Hello everybody, how are you? This is the second session. In this session, we will study together the sources of carbs and its importance inside our body. We'll talk about carbs as a source of, or as the main source of energy inside our body. Before that, we have to revise together what we took before, which is the classification of carbohydrates. As we said, we have two categories, which is simple carbs and complex carbs. In simple carbs, we have monosaccharides, three types of them: fructose, glucose, and galactose. Also, in simple carbs, we have disaccharide. In disaccharide, we have three types: sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Each one of them is formed by a combination of certain type of monosaccharide. They combine together through dehydration reaction or dehydration synthesis to form a certain type of disaccharide. You have to know that sucrose is formed by combination of fructose and glucose. Maltose is formed by the combination of two glucose. Lactose is formed by the combination of galactose and glucose. And those together are considered to be simple sugar. The complex sugar, which is polysaccharide, as we see that example of it is starch. Polysaccharide is the result of combination between more than three monosaccharides that are linked together by bond. If you want to compare between polysaccharide and both of mono and disaccharides, we'll find that this one is more complex. It contains more number of saccharides that are linked together, so it needs time to be digested and then to be absorbed by our body. For monosaccharide and disaccharide, it will be digested quickly and it will be absorbed also in a quick way. So, if you want to talk about the sources of carbohydrates, we have in this figure an example for each one of them. If you take a look, we have complex carbs, tubers like potato or sweet potato. We also have green vegetables like broccoli, certain type of fruits like banana and berries. Also, we have like whole grains, bread, or brown pasta. For simple carbs, common type or any food that's considered to be too sweet, like donuts, fries, chocolate, soda, certain type of syrup, fries, and white bread. If you want to compare between the two sources of carbs, complex carbs, any food that is starchy and it is full of fibers and it needs time to be digested. Simple carbs, you can find them in the sweet food and it needs less time to be digested. For white bread, whenever we are chewing a piece of white bread, at the end of this process, we will be able to taste like a sweet taste. This sweet taste is the result of digestion of the bread inside our mouth. Since carbohydrates or carbs, digestion of carbs will start inside our mouth through the digestive tract and it will end in the small intestine where it should be digested into small or into simple sugar, then to be absorbed by our blood and circulate through our blood to the cells that needs energy to generate its activity. Again, together, simple carbs are broken down quickly by our body examples of them, we have natural simple carbohydrates and processed carbohydrates. For natural food like fruits and milk, for the processed one we have like candy, syrup and soft drinks. Complex carbohydrates, they are much denser. I mean that they are packed with the nutrients and fibers. They are good for our digestive tract. They are digested slowly, but they make us feel like more full. So it takes time to be digested, and it is a good option if you want to control our weight. Examples of them, we can find complex carbohydrate in legumes, we can find them in starchy vegetables. Right. Function of carbohydrates. We'll talk about the function of carbohydrates for our body. Three main functions of them. First one is to provide our body with energy, especially the brain, since it needs energy to function well. Second function of it, it spares the protein. The last one, it helps in fat metabolism. Of course, we will take each one of them and we'll talk about them separately. Today, we'll just take the first part of carbohydrate function, which is it provides energy for our brain. So, how it generates energy? While we are enjoying the meal that's full of carbohydrates, our body will start to digest it through the digestive tract. The digestion of carbohydrate will start in mouth by certain enzyme, and then it will continue to be digested through the small intestine, which will be absorbed at the end of digestion by blood, and then the blood will carry the sugar or the glucose to the body cell to carry its own activity. It's important to take adequate quantity of carbohydrates so we will be able to do our daily activity. If we are going or if you are taking a low carb diet, we will feel or we will have certain symptoms at the beginning, like headache, or we will feel foggy. That's why the brain mainly can work only with the aid of glucose. Or the glucose considered to be the first type of fuel for our brain. So most of our body cells, they need the simple carbohydrates as glucose for generating energy. We can know that carbs are so important for our body. When we are following like a low carb diet, we'll feel headache, fatigue, we'll feel that our brain foggy for a few days. That's why we have shortened supply of energy, or our body will try to find alternative source of energy so they can generate well. This is happen if we are following keto diet. If you know what is keto diet, it is a type of diet where we cut all the sources of carbohydrates and depend on fats. Fats will be broken down into ketones, and our body will be in ketosis. That means that our body will use ketones as a first fuel or as a first first source of energy instead of glucose. In the third session, we will take the two functions, the two other functions of carbohydrates, which is sparing protein and also helps in metabolism of fats.